Hello, hello from IPSOC 18 in Grenoble, France. I am with the little IP provider called Synopsys. You know, we say the company acquires everybody else in a very long acquisition tree. I have the pleasure to be with Ruud Dervik. He's from the Netherlands. And I think he's a system architect. And I think you're highly specialized in security, because I listened a little bit to your talk, and you had a lot to say about what Synopsys provides in the security area. So the difficult point will be to summarize that for our audience in a reasonable amount of time. So please.
Thank you, Gabriel. So it's great to be here at IPSOC, yet another IPSOC. And indeed, I've spoken about security. So that's the main area I'm working in. Synopsys actually does a lot of things, as you mentioned, a lot of acquisitions. So the topic of my talk was actually security from software to silicon, or from silicon to software. So Synopsys started EDA, it has a large IP offering, but recent years also quite some investments were done in security, including a lot of software tools companies that were added. So in my presentation, I gave an overview of all of the Synopsys technologies. I don't have the time to repeat that that story. I think these slides will be online anyway. And so let me just highlight a few of the topics that I spoke about. So Synopsys has, on the IP side, several building blocks to build secure SOCs. So for instance, on the processor IP side, we have the ARC processor, and we have a say security hardened variant of that ARC, the ARC SEM, that adds a lot of security features, both on so-called logical protection, so on the software side. For instance, to combine secure software and normal software on a single processor, and then to sandbox that security software in a trusted execution environment. It's a technology called Secure Shield. Besides these ARC SEM processors, there's solutions for cryptography. And there, the solutions range from software solutions only, running on a secure processor, to hardware solutions, so full hardware engines that can be as large and as powerful as your application requires. But also in the middle, we have a solution which is a combined hardware-software solution, where we extend the ARC processor with dedicated instructions to do crypto processing. So these give a very good speed up, a very good balance between additional area, additional power, and the performance. Now, besides these building blocks on the hardware side, we have software building blocks like software crypto library, secure boot toolkits, and more. Since security is quite hard, what we also do is provide subsystems that pre-integrate those components. So these are branded under the T-Root name. These integrate the hardware components, these add software. There's variants of T-Root that are still programmable, meaning customers can add their own software or tailor the software. And there's solutions where Synopsys takes the complete responsibility for the so-called security boundary. So the software in the subsystem is owned by Synopsys, is programmed by Synopsys, is verified and tested by Synopsys, which gives you a complete security solution. Now, one of the applications for T-Root is a new, I would call it, trend over the last years, but it's really emerging in the market now. That's called embedded SIM. So you know the SIM cards that go in phones, well, they became smaller and smaller. But here I have a prototype of the latest form factor of Synopsys. So it's large again, right? You see the phone, it's connected with a cable to a development board. So this development board obviously is large. It has an FPGA that holds the T-Root subsystem. and a eSIM software stack. So the idea with eSIM, embedded SIM, is that you don't switch the physical SIM card, but that you actually provision over the air the phone details, the keys and the phone number, etc. So that's very suitable for instance, for IoT. If you have a device that's on a remote location, you cannot go there and put in a new SIM card, so you can provision them over the air. Embedded SIM is a small chip that's soldered on the board. The next integration, of course, is to have an IP subsystem that you can integrate with your silicon, with your SoC, providing even bigger savings and benefits. So that's what's in this demo kit. Inside the FPGA, there's the T-Root version with the eSIM software, which could be integrated for instance, low-cost IoT devices. So this is one example. There's many other applications of the security IP. I think we are heading for an interesting time with more and more security.
Obviously security is the hot topic. I think there are some hot topics, low power, security are certainly the ones. I'm sure that Synopsys will go straight on the top.
Okay. From silicon to software.
Yes. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.